Almost 100 years ago, the Harlem Renaissance poet Langston Hughes wrote, "What happens to a dream deferred? Does it dry up like a raisin in the sun? Or fester like a sore and then run? Does it stink like rotten meat? Or crust and sugar over like a syrupy sweet? Maybe it just sags like a heavy load. Or does it explode?"
Development.
Relief.
Education.
Alien.
Miners.
When I think of dreams, I think of having your mind being able to create a vision of something that we don't know and don't feel.
Every year, 65,000 undocumented students graduate from U.S. high schools.
I think of something that can only be attained in a fantasy, and citizenship for the purpose of a better education shouldn't be a dream, it should be a reality for everyone.
I think of being able to imagine infinite possibilities to provide change for the better, for you, for society, and for the world.
When I think of dream, I think of opportunity and the possibility for a better future.
Many of those students are honor students, aspiring professionals, athletes, and student leaders.
Designed to help hundreds of thousands of kids who are brought here by their parents.
In the late 1800s, there was an influx of immigrants from Ireland and Asia.
In the 1920s, there was another surge of immigrants from Western Europe coming into the U.S.
Nearly 100 years later, in the new millennium, the need for migration hasn't lessened, but the faces have changed. The majority of immigrants coming to the U.S. are currently of Hispanic origin.
Young people are held liable for the transgression of their parents.
So if the dream acts has, it's like the world will open up. We will start again believing in the American dream, where everybody in America, if they work hard, they can do it.
These are children that are only asking, they're not asking for a free giveaway. They're asking for an opportunity. And if you deny them that opportunity, you're denying the nation an opportunity of future leaders that could change this nation and take it to the next.
Today, there are hundreds of thousands of students excelling in our schools who are not American citizens. Some are the children of undocumented workers who had nothing to do with the actions of their parents. They grew up as Americans and pledge allegiance to our flag, and yet they live every day with the threat of deportation. Others come here from abroad to study in our colleges and universities. But as soon as they obtain advanced degrees, we send them back home to compete against us. It makes no sense. Now, I strongly believe that we should take on once and for all the issue of illegal immigration.
Thank you for your time, and please support the DREAM Act by applying Aspira's AAA process in your community. Bring awareness to this topic and make sure those around you analyze this topic in a way that is informed and respectful. Also remember to develop an action plan towards this issue that is proactive rather than reactive. This is a very important issue to us all.